heavenly King, the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who art everywhere present and fillest all things, treasury of blessings and giver of life, come and abide in us and cleanse us from every impurity, and save our souls, O good one. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions, O Holy One, visit, and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and our God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Hearken, O Lord, unto my righteousness, and attend unto my supplication. Give ear unto my prayer, which cometh not from deceitful lips. From before thy face let my judgment come forth, let mine eyes behold uprightness. Thou hast proved my heart, thou hast visited it in the night. Thou hast tried me by fire, and unrighteousness was not found in me. That my mouth might not speak of the works of men, for the sake of the words of thy lips have I kept the ways that are hard. Set my footsteps in thy paths, that my steps may not be shaken. I have cried, for thou hast hearkened unto me, O God. Incline thine ear unto me, and hearken unto my words. Let thy mercies be made wonderful, O thou that savest them that hope in thee. From them that have resisted thy right hand, keep me, O Lord, as the apple of thine eye. In the shelter of thy wings wilt thou shelter me from the face of the ungodly, which have oppressed me. Mine enemies have surrounded my soul. They have enclosed themselves with their own fat. Their mouth hath spoken pride. They that cast me out have now encircled me. They have set their eyes to look askance on the earth. They have taken me as might a lion ready for his prey, and as might a lion's whelp that dwelleth in hiding. Arise, O Lord, overtake them and trip their heels. Deliver my soul from ungodly men, thy sword from the enemies of thy hand. O Lord, from thy few do thou separate them from the earth in their life. Yea, with thy hidden treasures hath their belly been filled. They have satisfied themselves with swine, and have left the remnants to their babes. But as for me, in righteousness shall I appear before thy face. I shall be filled when thy glory is made manifest to me. Unto thee, O Lord, have I lifted up my soul. O my God, in thee have I trusted. Let me never be put to shame, nor let mine enemies laugh me to scorn. Yea, let none that wait on thee be put to shame. Let them be ashamed which are lawless without a cause. Make thy ways, O Lord, known unto me, and teach me thy path. Lead me in thy truth, and teach me, for thou art God, my Savior. For on thee have I waited all the day long. Remember thy compassions, O Lord, and thy mercies, for they are from everlasting. The sins of my youth and mine ignorances remember not. According to thy mercy, remember thou me. For the sake of thy goodness, O Lord, good and upright is the Lord. Therefore will he set a law for them that sin in the way. He will guide the meek in judgment. He will teach the meek his ways. All the ways of the Lord are mercy and truth unto them that seek after his covenant and his testimonies. For the sake of thy name, O Lord, be gracious unto my sin, for it is great. Who is the man that feareth the Lord? He will set him a law in the way which he hath chosen. His soul shall dwell among good things, and his seed shall inherit the earth. The Lord is the strength of them that fear him, and his covenant shall be manifested unto them. Mine eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he it is that will draw my feet out of the snare. Look upon me and have mercy on me, for I am one only begotten and poor. The afflictions of my heart are multiplied. Bring me out from my necessities. Behold my lowliness and my toil, and forgive all my sins. Look upon mine enemies, for they are multiplied, and with an unjust hatred have they hated me. Keep my soul and rescue me. Let me not be put to shame, for I have hoped in thee. The innocent and the upright have cleaved unto me, for I have waited on thee, O Lord. Redeem Israel, O God, out of all his afflictions. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, according to the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions and my sin is ever before me. Against thee, thee only, have I sinned and done that which is evil in thy sight, so that thou art justified in thy sentence and blameless in thy judgment. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sins did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward being. Therefore teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Fill me with joy and gladness. Let the bones which thou hast broken rejoice. Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with a willing spirit. Then I will teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners will return to thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue will sing aloud of thy deliverance. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise. For thou hast no delight in sacrifice. Were I to give a burnt offering, thou wouldst not be pleased. The sacrifice acceptable to God is a broken spirit. A broken and contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy good pleasure and design. Rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Then wilt thou delight in right sacrifices, in burnt offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then bulls will be offered upon thine altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. By thy cross thou didst destroy death, and to the thief thou didst open paradise. For the myrrh-bearers thou didst change weeping into joy. And thou didst command thy disciples, O Christ God, to proclaim that thou art risen, granting the world great mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Long-suffering James, thou didst astound all by enduring horrible tortures with great patience. As the evil assembly performed the slaughter, thou didst utter prayers of thanksgiving to the Lord. Through thy suffering, thou didst receive thy crown and didst come to the throne of the heavenly King, Christ God, entreat him to save our souls, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Mother of God, thou art the true vine that hath blossomed forth for us the fruit of life. Thee do we supplicate, intercede, O Lady, together with the holy apostles, that our souls find mercy. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord day by day. The God of our salvation shall prosper us along the way. Our God is the God of salvation. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. The dominion of death can no longer hold men captive, for Christ descended, shattering and destroying its powers. Hell is bound while the prophets rejoice and cry, the Savior has come to those in faith. Enter, you faithful, into the resurrection. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. Thou who at all times and every hour in heaven and earth art worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, who art long-suffering, plenteous in mercy, most compassionate, who lovest the righteous and hast mercy on sinners, who callest all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, and guide our life toward thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Compass us about with thy holy angels, that guarded and guided by their ray, we may attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, glory to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim, without corruption thou gavest birth to God the Word. True Theotokos, we magnify thee. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Do the prayers of our Holy Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God. Have mercy on us.
Amen. O Master God, the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ and Holy Spirit, one Godhead, one power, have mercy on me, a sinner, and by the judgments which thou knowest, save me, thine unworthy servant, for blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and our God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. O God, in thy name save me, and in thy strength do thou judge me. O God, hearken unto my prayer, give ear unto the words of my mouth. For strangers are risen up against me, and mighty men have sought after my soul, and have not set God before themselves. For behold, God helpeth me, and the Lord is the protector of my soul. He will bring evils upon mine enemies, utterly destroy them by thy truth. Willingly shall I sacrifice unto thee. I will confess thy name, O Lord, for it is good. For out of every affliction hast thou delivered me, and mine eye hath looked down upon mine enemies. Give ear, O God, unto my prayer, and disdain not my supplication. Attend unto me and hear me. I was grieved in my meditation, and I was troubled at the voice of the enemy and at the oppression of the sinner, because they have turned iniquity upon me, and with wrath were they angry against me. My heart is troubled within me, and the terror of darkness hath covered me. And I said, who will give me wings like a dove? And I will fly and be at rest. Lo, I have fled afar off and have dwelt in the wilderness. I waited for God that saveth me from faintheartedness and from tempest. Plunge them into the depths, O Lord, and divide their tongues. For I have seen iniquity and gainsaying in the city. Day and night they go round about her upon her walls. Iniquity and toil and unrighteousness are in the midst of her. And usury and deceit have not departed from her streets. For if mine enemy had reviled me, I might have endured it. And if he that hateth me had spoken boastful words against me, I might have hid myself from him. But thou wast, O man of like soul with me, my guide and my familiar friend, thou who together with me didst sweeten my repast in the house of God, I walk with thee in oneness of mind. Let death come upon such ones, and let them go down alive into Hades. For darkness is in their dwellings, and in the midst of them. As for me, unto God have I cried, and the Lord hearkened unto me. Evening, morning, and noonday will I tell of it, and will declare it, and he will hear my voice. He will redeem my soul in peace from them that draw nigh unto me, for they among many were with me. God will hear, and he will humble them, he that is before the ages. For to them there is no requital, because they have not feared God. He hath stretched forth his hand in retribution. They have defiled his covenant. They were scattered by the wrath of his countenance, and their hearts have convened. Their words were smoother than oil, and yet they are darts. Cast thy care upon the Lord, and he will nourish thee. He will never permit the righteous to be shaken. But thou, O God, shalt bring those men down into the pit of destruction. Bloody and deceitful men shall not live out half their days. But as for me, O Lord, I will hope in thee. He that dwelleth in the help of the Most High shall abide in the shelter of the God of heaven. He shall say unto the Lord, thou art my helper and my refuge. He is my God, and I will hope in him. For he shall deliver thee from the snare of the hunters and from every troubling word. With his shoulders will he overshadow thee, and under his wings shalt thou have hope. With the shield will his truth encompass thee. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the thing that walketh in darkness, nor for the misshapen demon of noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but unto thee shall it not come nigh. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold, and thou shalt see the reward of sinners. For thou, O Lord, art my hope. Thou madest the Most High thy refuge. No evil shall come nigh thee, and no scourge shall draw nigh unto thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. On their hands shall they bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. Upon the aspen basilisk shalt thou tread, and thou shalt trample upon the lion and dragon. For he hath set his hope on me, and I will deliver him. I will shelter him, because he hath known my name. He shall cry unto me, and I will hearken unto him. I am with him in affliction, and I will rescue him and glorify him. With length of days will I satisfy him, and I will show him my salvation. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. By thy cross, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, by thy cross thou didst destroy death, to the thief thou didst open paradise. For the myrrhbearers thou didst change weeping into joy. And thou didst command thy disciples, O Christ God, to proclaim that thou art risen, granting the world great mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Long-suffering James, thou didst astound all by enduring horrible tortures with great patience. As the evil assembly performed the slaughter, thou didst utter prayers of thanksgiving to the Lord. Through thy sufferings, thou didst receive thy crown, and didst come to the throne of the heavenly King Christ God. Entreat him to save our souls, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Seeing that we have no boldness on account of our many sins, do thou beseech him that was born of thee, O Virgin Theotokos, for the supplication of a mother availeth much to win the Master's favor. Disdain not the prayers of sinners, all pure one, for merciful and mighty to save is he who deigned also to suffer for our sake. Let thy compassions quickly go before us, O Lord, for we are become exceedingly poor. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the sake of the glory of thy name. O Lord, deliver us, and be gracious unto our sins, for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, glory to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
The dominion of death can no longer hold man captive, for Christ descended, shattering and destroying its bars, its powers. Hell is bound while the prophets rejoice and cry. The Savior has come to those in faith. Enter, ye faithful, into the resurrection. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. O thou who at all times, at every hour, in heaven and on earth, art worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, who art long-suffering, plenteous in mercy, most compassionate, who lovest the righteous and hast mercy on sinners, who callest all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, and guide our life toward thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Compass us round about with thy holy angels, that guarded and guided by their array, we may attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou, and to the ages of ages, amen. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages, amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim. Without corruption you gave birth to God the Word. True Theotokos, we magnify thee. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O God and Lord of hosts and maker of all creation, who by the tender compassion of thy mercy, which transcendeth comprehension, did send down thine only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the salvation of our race, and by his precious cross didst tear asunder the handwriting of our sins, and thereby didst triumph over the principalities and powers of darkness. Do thou thyself, O Master, lover of mankind, accept also from us sinners these prayers of thanksgiving and entreaty, and deliver us from every destructive and dark transgression, and from all enemies, visible and invisible, that seek to do us evil. Nail down our flesh with the fear of thee, and incline not our hearts unto words or thoughts of evil, but pierce our souls with longing for thee, so that ever looking to thee, and being guided by thy light as we behold thee, the unapproachable and everlasting light, we may send up unceasing praise and thanksgiving unto thee, the unoriginate Father, with thine only begotten Son, and thine all-holy and good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Wisdom, let us attend.
O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ. Save us, O Son of God, who art risen from the dead. Save us who sing to thee, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Grows into a holy temple in the Lord,
in whom ye also are being built together into a habitation of God through the Spirit.
Peace be to thee that readest.
And to thy spirit.
Wisdom.
The Alleluia is in the seventh tone. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Alleluia, Alleluia.
Thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to thy name, O Most High.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
To declare thy mercy in the morning and thy truth by night.
Alleluia,
instill in us also the fear of thy blessed commandments, and trample down our carnal desires, so we may pursue a spiritual way of life, both considering and doing all things while pleasing unto thee. For thou art the enlightenment of our souls and bodies, O Christ God, and unto thee we send glory together with thy Father, who is without beginning, and thine all holy and good and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Wisdom attend, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be to all.
And to thy Spirit.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee.
Let us attend. At that time, Jesus was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath. And there was a woman who had a spirit of infirmity for 18 years. She was bent over and could not fully straighten herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her and said to her, "Woman, you are freed from your infirmity." And he laid his hands upon her, and immediately she was made straight, and she praised God. But the ruler of the synagogue, indignant because Jesus had healed on the Sabbath, said to the people, "There are 6 days on which work ought to be done. Come on those days and be healed, and not on the Sabbath day." Then the Lord answered him, "You hypocrite! Does not each of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or his ass from the manger and lead it away to water it? And ought not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 years, be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day?" As Jesus said this, all his adversaries were put to shame, and all the people rejoiced at all the glorious things that were done by him.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. A persistent theme in Scripture is the tension between what humans should do and what they actually do. This really goes clear back to the fall, even before the fall, where Eve is battling this temptation to eat the fruit. Her will has not yet fallen, but it's being tested sorely. She has to be convinced to do what she does. But she does. Adam, when he tries to pass the buck, and that is what he's doing, when God himself faces him,
That woman you gave to me, she gave it to me to eat. In many ways, this is even the greater sin because he refuses to live up to that which was given to him to be and to do. He abdicated his role. Continues with Cain, who in his anger at being rejected, or rather his offering being rejected, he is told by no less than God himself, sin lies at the door, its desire is for you, and you must rule over it. This pattern is repeated over and over and over again in sins in the Bible. It's a never-ending, ugly story with, frankly, people who, well, in theory, should know better, nonetheless, do it anyway. They do it anyway. The whole account of Scripture has to do with the fact that man, after the fall, is a divided creature. He's almost schizophrenic. Mm-hmm. We have these brief moments of sanity when we live at peace with him, when we see the truth of him, his words, and his word with a capital W. When we see the truth of it, when we seek after his company, when we, again, in those rare moments, when we are happy to conform our lives and our thoughts to what we were created to be. But those are the briefest of moments compared to the absolute war that we ultimately wage against God the rest of the time. And really, there's no other word for it but war. We war when we're dominated by our selfishness and our self-will, where it's always me first. We war when we ignore those who are suffering, especially when it makes us uncomfortable. This can be everything from difficult relatives, people who are close to us, people whom we avoid, clear to people on the street whom we know could use a hand, and we don't do it because, well, they're just ripping people off. Well, that may be true. Is that all of it? We war when we are dominated by our desires for more of everything, whether it's stuff, whether it's comfort, whether it's money, whether it is security. We war when we fuel our lusts, contemplating acts, relationships, other things that are only destructive. And again, I would call attention to the fact that I am not speaking purely of the sex. I mean, the sex is bad enough. I mean, it's everywhere. But dare I say it, there's the food. I make the observation at a common gas station convenience store. They have an ad campaign where they call it, they're wanting to call it a snackle. And I don't mean them any disrespect, but the fact that this has appeal, because the question is it a meal or is it a snack? And the point being that we are really poorly disciplined about food. We'll eat ourselves into a stupor. I make fun of the dog for doing this kind of thing. But as people, we are all too prone to doing this. So it's not just the sex. It's the food. It's the endless shopping. The materialism. The desire for more. All of it. We war when we act on the thoughts to make it real. We war when we become angry at God for having the gall to tell us that these things are wrong, that they are not created to be. moments of sanity and peace and love and harmony with God. We live in a state of hostility, what the scriptures often refer to, at least in English, as enmity between us and God. That enmity leaves us divided and separated. Each one of us is in reality two individuals. We are divided in ourselves. All of which takes us to what St. Paul is talking about as he continues writing to the Ephesians. And remember, last week I talked a little bit about what Paul is doing in this letter to the Ephesians. They're mostly Gentiles. And so on the one hand, he has to remind them that, or reassure them rather, that they are in fact able to be inheritors of God's kingdom. He reminds them of that. But then he flips it around and reminds them that that doesn't mean you get to live in the sins that you walked away from. And so in elaborating these points, he wants them to realize the magnitude of the sin in order that they realize the magnitude of Christ's grace. He explains for them, as we heard today, that there is indeed a wall of separation that is between us and God. The thing is, God didn't build it. Oh, no, 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 no. Every human being has constructed himself or herself part of this wall, contributing all of the material that was needed to build it, whether it was the brick, the mortar, the steel, the wood, the fasteners, everything. Built it up piece by piece by piece, often humming happy tunes as we build it even higher. Even as God has been there quietly saying, stop. Against this wall of separation, against the accumulated enmity, that hostility between man and God, comes Jesus himself. And according to St. Paul, Christ himself is our peace. And I make an aside here, because there's all this talk about peace on earth, goodwill toward men. Christ himself is that peace. He is that goodwill toward men. This thing, this song that the angels sing that we remember in this very season isn't some sentimental thing. It's not Christ himself is our peace. He's the one that's being talked about. And in himself, he destroys that wall of separation between us and our Creator. He tears down not the old law, not to destroy it, but to make it fully effective. The law was training wheels of a sort. A way to live to keep them thoroughly out of the ditch, but they weren't the ultimate end by the law. No, Christ himself is the one who comes to make it full and complete in himself. And in himself, he takes this divided humanity. St. Paul talks about that in Christ, he makes out of two men, he makes one. And he's not talking about making one man in Christ, because Christ himself is not divided. Christ himself was not of that double mind. He had two natures, but he was not at war with God. No, the making two men out of one is about us, about each and every one of us, to fix this ugly rift that exists within ourselves, to put us together with his perfect union. Between the divine and the humanity, becoming the basis for us to become single once again. In himself, he ascends the cross in order to bring about the end of that war. war between us and the Father. He takes each of our divided selves, that sane part and that insane part, two people, effectively, and makes them one, held together, drawn together, knitted back together by his own blood running down on that ugly piece of wood. And that blood does so much. It ends the Father's anger. It buys us back from the evil one. It's his own life poured up on and even into us. Even given to us as nourishment in his mysteries. Each one of you who approaches the chalice and receives his body and blood hears these words, the servant of God and your name, receives the precious and holy body and blood of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ for the remission of his sins and unto life everlasting. Every time. When the priest goes back or the celebrant goes back into the altar, he even recalls Isaiah's vision. Remember where Isaiah, he simply stood before God having this vision. I'm a man of unclean lips, of a people of unclean lips. And the angel brings the hot coal from the censer and touches it to his lips and says, lo, this has touched your lips and shall take away your iniquity and cleanse all of your sins. It is a foretaste of the mysteries that we actually receive, our actual participation in that blood of the cross. Christ reconciling us to the Father, my brothers and sisters, is the peace of God. It's not that sentimental, sappy peace stuff that we so associate with at this time of year, but it's real peace accomplished by Christ himself, overcoming the war that each one of us wages against God, the war that we seem and indeed are utterly incapable of stopping. Receive this peace of God, Christ himself, and seek to join yourself to it, recognizing it for what it is, expanding those moments of sanity, and waging war where it should truly be waged, which is to say, against sin, until he comes again to manifest it, that final victory in all its fullness. Amen.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord.
Brother Deacon Paul, and for all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox, God to rest before us who lie here and everywhere.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and forgiveness of sins of the servants of God. Archbishop Melchizedek, Archbishop Benjamin, Eamon Patrick, Archpriest Thomas, Reader Mark, Paul, Timothy, Catherine, Cosmos, Joseph, Stephen, Jeremiah, Alexis, Barbara, Theodore, Demetrius, Suzanne, John, Timothy, Anna, Catherine, Mary, Amelia, Sophia, the child John, Juliana, and the child reborn of her, Elizabeth, and the child reborn of her, and of our brethren of this holy temple.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we ask thy great mercy on our brothers and sisters who are presently involved in conflict, remove from their midst all hostility, confusion, and hatred. Lead everyone along the path of reconciliation and peace, we pray thee. Hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bear fruit and do good works in this holy and revered temple, for those who labor and those who sing, and for the people here present who await to be great and preach mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For thou art a merciful God who lovest man and unto thee do we send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray unto the Lord, ye catechumens.
Lord, have mercy.
Ye faithful, pray for the catechumens of the Lord, and have mercy on them.
Lord, have mercy.
Be instructed in the word of truth.
Lord, have mercy.
Reveal unto them the gospel of righteousness.
Lord, have mercy.
May he unite you unto his holy Catholic and apostolic church.
Lord, have mercy.
Take and have mercy on them. Help them and keep them, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Bow your heads to the Lord, ye catechumens. Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Beatitude Tikhon, Archbishop of Washington, Metropolitan of All America and Canada, and His Eminence Alexander, Archbishop of Dallas and the South, may the Lord God remember in His kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. The President of our country, all civil authorities and the armed forces, may the Lord God remember in His kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Those who departed this life in faith and hope of the resurrection, especially the newly departed Igumen Victor and the priest, Andrew, the protodeacon Paul, may the Lord God remember in His kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. The sick and the suffering servants of God, and those who have asked us in our unworthiness to pray for them, especially the servants of God, Archpriest Thomas, Reader Mark, Catherine, Cosmas, Theodore, Anna, Demetrius, Catherine, Mary, Amelia, the child John, Sophia, Juliana, and the child to be born of her, Elizabeth, and the child to be born of her. May the Lord God remember in His kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. All those suffering persecution, captivity, and death, for the sake of the name of Christ, may the Lord God remember in His kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. You and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember in His kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. That we may receive the King of all, who comes in
and the divine. The door and the love of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is meet and right to worship Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Trinity, one in essence and undivided.
It is meet and right to him be to bless thee, to praise thee, to give thanks unto thee, and to worship thee in every place of thy dominion. For thou art God, inexpressible, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing, eternally the same, thou, my only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit. Thou didst bring us from non-existence into being, and when we had fallen away, the source of it again, it did not cease to do all things, until thou hast brought us up to heaven, and hast bestowed upon us thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee, and to thy only begotten Son, and to thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which are not unwritten, and not for the benefit of those revealed, and not revealed, that have been done to us. And we give thanks unto thee for this service which thou hast vouchsafed to accept from our hands, even though we stand beside thee thousands of archangels, and 10,000s of angels, cherubim and seraphim, six winged many eyes, borne aloft on their wings, singing the hymn of victory, shouting, crying, and saying,
oh,
again we offer unto thee this rational worship for those who in faith have gone before their rest, forefathers, scholars, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and for every righteous spirit and faith made perfect. Especially our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary.
Give us this day
those who bow their heads on thee, they have not bowed down to the flesh and blood of the king. Now therefore, mess is done, the suffering to the peaceful. Here set forth in the power of good according to the individual need of each. Trouble those that journey by land, by sea, by air, and by space. Heal the sick, for thou physician of our souls and bodies. Through the grace and love, compassion and love of man, of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed together, for thou, holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us attend to the holy things or for the holy.
One is for holy. One is for Jesus Christ. To the glory of God the Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries
condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body. Amen.
In the fear of God and with faith and love, draw near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us.
The servant of God,
and our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Give thanks to thee, O Master of those mankind, benefactor of our souls, so that thou hast vouchsafed unto us this present day thy heavenly and immortal mysteries. Make our way straight, establish us all in thy fear. Guard our life, make firm our steps, through the prayers and supplications of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary and of all thy saints. For thou art a sanctification, and into thee do we send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. And bless thy inheritance, preserve the fullness of thy church, sanctify those that love the beauty of thy house, glorify them in return by thy divine power, and forsake us not that hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee do we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord henceforth and forevermore. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be continually in my mouth. In the Lord my soul shall make good. Let the meek hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my afflictions. Draw nigh to him and be enlightened, and your faces shall not be ashamed. This forlorn bride in the Lord heard him, and saved him from all his tribulations. The angel of the Lord will encamp round about them that fear him, and shall deliver them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who hopeth in him. Fear the Lord, O ye his saints, for there is no life for them that fear him. The rich have become poor and hungry, but them that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing.
The blessing of the Lord and his mercy be upon you through his grace and love for man always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Father, bless.
May he who is risen from the dead, Christ, our true God, through the intercessions of his all-immaculate mother, of the honorable, glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all honorable apostles, and victorious, of Agatha, the patron of this holy temple, of the great martyr James the Persian, who we commemorate today, and of the holy, righteous forebears of God, Joachim, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loveth mankind.
His beatitude, the most blessed Tecon, Archbishop of Washington, Metropolitan of all America and Canada. His Eminence the Right Reverend Alexander, Archbishop of Dallas and the South. This God protected land, all civil authorities, and all of the last Christians. Preserve, O Lord, for many years.
Now, glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory forever.
I hope each and every one of you have a blessed Thanksgiving week. This, of course, is the weekend following Thanksgiving, and there are a number of other people that I've received notice of that are ill.
So a few things on the announcement fronts. First of all, this Wednesday is actually a reader vespers on Wednesday. Family commitment that is that night. So I will not be here to serve vespers, but there will be vespers held, so please come. Additionally, next Sunday, starting at 9 a.m., I will be doing the preparation of the gifts, the proscomedi or the proscomedia, depending on what language you like it in. But I will be doing the preparation service. So this is basically what happens with, you've seen breads go back and things like that. What is going on? And there is a service of preparation. It's actually part of the priest vesting. If you get here really early, you'll get to see me, doing all the vesting prayers and stuff that are part of it as I get my stuff on. And from there, what we'll do is we'll have the oblation table out here. We'll move it over to the side when we're done. But we'll have it out here, and we'll have some explanatory material available. And basically, let you see what all is going on. Again, usually this is conducted behind the scenes, and as you'll learn next weekend, doing it before the service was kind of a later development. Originally, it would actually take place in the middle of the liturgy. There'd be this delay in the middle while they would prepare the gifts, and eventually they didn't like the delay anymore, so they moved it to the beginning, and that's where it is now. But it's instructive, so we'll do it about once a year. You're welcome to come and see what all we do there. The final thing, and again, this is a little bit tweaky wrong on here, it is Monday, December 5th, because the 6th is a Tuesday, so the 5th. So the Monday is right, not the 6th, it's Monday. Monday the 5th, we will be serving Great Vespers for the Feast of St. Nicholas, which begins at sundown that day. And there will be some stuff for the kids to do, and that's always a big, kind of a fun thing. So by all means, mark your calendars and plan to be present for that one. We'll wait till the kids come down to do the name days, anniversaries, and birthdays. I'm making a grumble because word got out that today, yes, is my birthday. So there is no
hiding. Happy birthday, Father.
I knew there would be no hiding. So I'm ready for it. Anything else that I have forgotten?
Well, I just might ask if we could possibly get help next weekend, some man or men, to bring the Christmas tree decorations that we have in the shed out, because then we'll be able to get it set up Sunday.
So all of the strapping men, young and
all
old, you
strapped,
have been
yes.
conscripted
yes.
next weekend, we'll need to bring in the Christmas goodies.
Because
yes, that's a good
today.
Point, because on Saturday, well, mostly Sunday.
Yeah.
Sunday, we'll have time on Sunday.
We'll be decorating the,
checking the bells.
Getting more Christmas stuff out as we move closer to the Christmas season.
We might have a bigger crowd, too,
just
share the money. Yes.
Well, sickness is getting us hard.
Yeah.
Is,
so
I mean,
we should
it's
just
leave
the lifting only for you.
No.
Nah, I'm happy to hand that off. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O God.
Thank thee, O Lord, my God, that thou hast not rejected me a sinner, but hast vouchsafed me to be a communicant of thy holy things. I thank thee that thou hast vouchsafed me the unworthy to partake of thy most pure and heavenly gifts. But, O Master, lover of mankind, who for our sake didst die and rise again, and didst bestow upon us these dread and life-giving mysteries for the well-being and sanctification of our souls and bodies, grant that these may be even unto me, for the healing of both soul and body, for the averting of everything hostile, for the enlightenment of the eyes of my heart, for the peace of the powers of my soul, for faith unashamed, for love unfeigned, for the fullness of wisdom, for the keeping of thy commandments, for an increase of thy divine grace, and for the attainment of thy kingdom, that being preserved by them in thy holiness, I may always remember thy grace, and no longer live for myself, but for thee our master and benefactor. And thus when I shall have departed this life, in and hope of life eternal, I may attain unto everlasting rest. For the sound of them that keep festival is unceasing, and the delight of them is endless, that behold the ineffable beauty of thy countenance. For thou art the true desire and the unutterable gladness of them that love thee, O Christ our God, and all creation doth hymn thee unto the ages. Amen. O Master Christ God, King of the ages and Creator of all things, I thank thee for all the good things which thou hast bestowed upon me, for the communion of thy most pure and life-giving mysteries. I pray thee, therefore, O good one, lover of mankind, keep me under thy protection and in the shadow of thy wings, and grant me even unto my last breath to partake worthily